Let's talk Star Trek.
Space, the final frontier. Star Trek really freaks me out and stuff.
Hey, what's up, guys? Today I'm going to talk about fear. Because fear is the mind killer. And I'm a 90s kid, so remember the brand No Fear? I need to jump in a time machine and go back and get a No Fear shirt, because I might need it today, because we're going to look at three things from Star Trek The Next Generation that really scared me as a kid and continues to scare me today. Let's jump into it. So this first one, as you can see, there's three yellow shirt dudes. Geordi, some random white dude, random white lady. And then something happens and bam, she's stuck between decks, like just stuck in the floor. And that really stuck with me as a kid, like really freaked me out. Like I'm like, my child brain can't comprehend what I'm seeing. And so the lady stuck between decks is from Star Trek The Next Generation episode entitled In Thoery. So this episode is it's not a great one. It's all about Data. And so it starts out and like Data's like, yo, I want to get back in the dating pool, meet some hot blonde. I think he's got a thing for hot blondes, because you know, him and Tasha Yar, and now this new yellow shirt engineer and Wiz, and I don't know, they quickly move in together. And well, that's what the episode is supposed to be about, kind of like Data's thing. Some Star Trek-y stuff happens, and then you see this lady just trapped in the floor, and yo, she dead. You know, I don't think Dr. Crusher and all the King's Men can't put this poor lady back together again. Scary, right? You know, it's like some Star Trek phenomenon could happen, and that's the way to go. That's the way you're gonna die. It's like, I wonder if, like, what deck that happened on. Let's just say it's, oh, deck 13. Do you think someone on deck 12 could see her legs sticking to the floor? I think that's the way, like, the decks are numbered, like, lower decks and then all the way up to the bridge. I don't know. Don't quote me on that. I should research that, but I'm lazy. But, yeah, let's jump into the next one, shall we? All right, so the second thing is the Klingons. So as a kid, like, the Klingons had scary faces and kind of freaked me out, you know. Not as much as, like, say, the Ferengi or the first time you see a Cardassian. But nevertheless, the new Klingon look, you know, not the classic black-faced Klingons that, you know, we saw in the original run. But, yeah, the new, you know. It's like the Star Trek II, like, Klingons. Like, something happened, and I kind of want to blame, like, Christopher Lloyd. Like, maybe he had a part in this, and he's like, great Scott, we gotta make these Klingons look different. 88 miles per hour, Marty. But I don't know, man. I think they just scared him up, you know. Like, let's put some stuff on their foreheads, give them some sweet long hair, and then I don't know, let's put them in, like, Kiss regalia. And then, I don't know, let's make it even worse. Let's give him some bad teeth. But, there's two Klingons that, kind of scared me as a kid. But not, like, scared in, like, the, stereotypical fear-based reaction. These are two ladies that, you know, I think are kind of sexy. And, kind of confused me as a young man. Confused me as a boy and still confuses me today. Sexually? I don't know, let's just take a look at these. Just look at them. It's just, they're all, like, hair. Like, I dig long hair. I dig, you know, long curly hair. It's my jam. And boobs, you know, just the way that cleavage is just pushed together in that, like, badass, like, Klingon getup. Yeah, really kind of freaked me out as I was maturing into adolescence, and it really freaks me out as an adult. Like, is this what I'm into now? Is this what life's all about? I have a book, and it's a Klingon to English dictionary. It's like, teach yourself to speak Klingon, just in case you ever meet a Klingon lady with that sweet ass cleavage and I don't know, a bat left that's coming at your face, dude. I'll know what to do. Will you? There's no fear, because I'm wearing a no fear shirt, and I can speak Klingon poorly, but I can speak Klingon. I'm gonna start putting that on my resume. Take that, Lars and Bador. They're from episode. Well, this little snippet's from the episode, the two-parter, Redemption Part 1, Redemption Part 2. Still, the weirdest part of this scene is, I don't know if it's Lursa or Bator that's just being real seductive with the captain. She's like giving him some sweet head touches, like, you know, the head that's on top of your neck, not the one in your pants. I bet she's real gentle with that too. That might get edited out, but probably not, because I'm lazy and it's funny. If you don't think that's funny, you know, that's on you. And then she starts, like, talking about, like, oh, I heard you like tea. Let me push my tits together and pour this tea all sexy-like. And me, as an avid viewer of, you know, the human condition and all things weird science. Weird science. I don't know. I just sit kind of like, I'm like, she's sexy. She knows what she's doing. You know, I bet. I don't know if it's Lursa or Vader, but I think. Do you think there's Klingon strip clubs? Like, Klingon warriors just going in there and, like, no targs allowed. And, you know, they gotta leave their batleth and cool blasters at the door. And maybe it's like a little cantina like the one on Mos Eisley. That's Star Wars for all the Star Trek people, you know. Sorry, I had to mention a Star Wars thing, but, hey man, I'm a fanboy and a Trekkie. I don't think there's a word for it. It's just nerdy, I guess. But yeah, so Klingon strip clubs, you know, I wonder if it's going to be, if it's just like, I bet it's badass. I bet they serve like the best drinks, you know, blood wine. They probably serve Kanar. I don't know, some of that Romulan blue whiskey and, I don't know, whatever Whoopi's serving up on the old Big D. So, I don't know, some 10-forward happy hour special drinks. Plus, you know, a little quick Klingon twist.
What the twist?
Yeah, who knows, you know. I'm a whiskey sour man myself, I don't drink anymore, but that was my drink of choice, and I bet I could get a badass whiskey sour at a Klingon strip club. Do you think there's enough nerds out there that I could open a Klingon strip club? Like, so Star Trek Vegas is happening next month, and I'm wondering if I could do like a pop-up Klingon strip club. How many strippers would be down to put on the head loaf and just dance, you know? And you get some like shiny bikinis, and who knows? Maybe I'll do it. Maybe next year. Like, maybe it could be a thing. Like, New York Comic Con is in October this year, or November. October, November this year. Like, what if it's a hit in Vegas, and then I can take it on the road, you know? And it'll be next stop, New York, and then next stop, Seattle Comic Con 2022, and then who knows, maybe the big one, the San Diego Comic Con, and next summer, and all the little cons in between, and back to Star Trek Las Vegas and next year. Who knows? It'll be cool. Maybe I get Michael Dorn out there just making it rain. Be a good time. Come check it out. Klingon strip clubs. It'll be a lot of fun. I think. Probably. Maybe no one will show up, just like me and my friends. And I don't know. I'll still have a good time. Who knows? Well, this next one, this one really takes the cake for me, because as a kid, I watched Star Trek with my dad. And this episode freaked me out so much that my mom's like, hey, can we, like, turn it off and you can finish this later when little baby Adam's not in the room freaking out at what he's seen on the television screen. My mom doesn't talk like that. I don't know why I did that accent. Is that cultural appropriation for me to do a southern slang? I don't know. There's Asian people that talk with that southern drawl. You don't know. You don't know me. You don't know my mama. But yeah, this one, it's from season 2, and in the episode's entitled Where Silence Has Lease, and it's a scary episode, and oftentimes when I'm binge-watching Star Trek, you know, on CBS, oh no, it's not CBS All Access, now it's called Paramount Plus, I oftentimes will just skip this episode altogether, because I may have PTSD from this. I might have to do like EMDR or some ketamine and try to disassociate and forget about this episode entirely. But so this episode, the crew, find themselves in like this weird Star Trek nebula, and it just shit just gets weird, and then all of a sudden this like face shows up. So this no good face monster, space face monster, has a name. His name is Nigilum, but I'll just refer to him as the face. And this face, he's like, I chose this face to look more like you, but he doesn't look like people. He looks like a stretched out monster cat man. And he's just up to no good. Like right off the bat, he's like, what's up with you, this doctor? What? And it's the whole thing. He's like, oh, I can't tell genders, which, you know, yeah, he's living in 2021, I guess. But then he's like, what's this death all about? And just straight offs it, dude. He offs one of the driver. He offs the driver of the Enterprise. And, that scene just scared the shit out of little baby Adam. And really, just today scares me. Like, the actor does this thing where he, like, convulses and, like, falls to the ground. And, like, it's just, like, fear that killed him, man. And I don't know, it's like weird. As I was prepping the video for this, I'm like, yeah, it still gives me like this weird heebie-jeebie chills. And sorry I did the accent again, but you can't stop me. Freaked me out. And I don't know, I'm still like thinking in that face, man. It shows up throughout the episode and continues to scare me. So yeah, it's one of the episodes that I oftentimes will skip. Like, hey man, I watched Star Trek to wind down after a long day at the office, and last thing I need is fear keeping me up all night. And I have a friend named Byron, and he's like, I can't believe you watched Star Trek before bed. I'm like, why is that? He's like, that shit gives you nightmares, dog. And I'm like, does it?
Does it?
I have nightmares every night. Thanks for listening.